In this video, we're going to cover how to set up the In-Sight emulator and how to load images so that we can start programming. In-Sight Explorer is typically used to program a camera that is connected to, but you can practice using it or fine-tune a program you already have without having a camera connected. In this case, you'll need to connect to an emulator. An emulator acts like the actual camera is emulating, so to use it properly, you need to pick the correct camera you are trying to emulate. To change the settings of the emulator, you need to go to System, Options, Emulation, and under the Model dropdown, select the correct camera. For our labs, some of them will use Standard. This is a 640 by 480 resolution camera, and other labs will use the In-Sight 7200. This is the camera that we have in our lab, and it has a resolution of 800 by 600. In this options panel, also note the registration section. If you haven't entered an offline programming key, then you need to go to the Cognex website to generate a key. Until you do this, you won't be able to use the emulator. To see if you're connected to the emulator, click Get Connected under the application steps, and in the bottom left part of the screen, you'll see your computer name followed by Local Emulator in brackets. Select it and click Connect. Once you have the correct emulator settings and you're connected to it, you'll need to load some images to create your program. Click on Setup Image and in the lower left of the screen, select Load Images from PC. You can also get there by clicking the folder icon at the top of the screen or by selecting Record Playback options under the Image menu. Under the Playback tab, select the folder that contains the images you want to play back. I have a folder of images stored on my desktop. You can now navigate through the images by using the playback controls at the top of the screen or by using the film strip controls. If the film strip is not visible, you can enable or disable it by clicking the film strip icon or by selecting film strip under the View menu. The film strip has the advantage of being able to see a number of images in your set of images. You can also jump directly to a particular image without having to step through each image. But it has the downside of taking up more space that could be used to display the image that you're working on. Now that you're connected to the emulator and have images loaded, you're ready to start programming.